Welcome to this video lecture series on antenna and wave propagation. In this video, we'll discuss the reflector antennas and its types. So first, we'll begin with the definition of reflector antennas and then we'll discuss its various types. So let's begin. So what is a reflector antenna? So reflector antenna is basically, it's not an antenna, it's a reflecting surface. So it is a reflecting surface which acts like a passive element. So what is a passive element? Passive element is the element which is not connected to the feed line. So reflector antenna is actually not an antenna, it's just a surface which reflects the EM wave. It's not connected to the feed line. So the elements which are connected to the feed line are called active elements. So active elements are connected to the feed line. So I hope you understand the difference between passive elements and active elements. So next thing about reflector antennas is that it works at higher frequencies. It works at high frequencies, that is megahertz. So why at higher frequencies? Because at high frequencies, the EM waves or the electromagnetic waves act like the ray of light. So it exhibits the phenomena that is shown by the light. So light reflects when it strikes a polished surface. So similarly, EM waves also get reflected when it strikes a polished surface, which is called reflector antenna. So this phenomena work as at higher frequencies, that is megahertz. So the next thing about reflector antennas is that it is highly directional in nature. That is, it is highly directional in nature and it is used for long distance communication. So why it is so? So mostly our antennas are bidirectional in nature. That is, it's radiating in two directions, east or west or north or south. So if I have to connect to a receiving antenna, my receiving antenna would be on only one side. It does not require the radiations to go in two sides. So if I can transmit my radiations only in one side, so reflector antenna is reflecting the rays and the rays are going only to the one side, which is increasing the directional property of the antenna. So now I can say the reflector antenna are highly directional, so it can be used for long distance communication. So let's come to the types of reflector antenna. So first type is large flat sheet reflector. So large flat sheet reflector, as the name is suggesting, I have a large flat sheet. So now this large flat sheet is a polished surface which can reflect my EM waves, or it's a surface which have the property to reflect my EM waves. So now if I have, so now this consists, this is called my thin linear antenna. This structure is denoting my thin linear antenna, which is connected to the feed. Now this squared out portion is called, it's a bigger reflecting surface in the back side of the antenna, and in the front side I have the receiving antenna. So what would happen? This portion or this reflecting surface is called large flat sheet reflector. And this reflecting surface is used to reflect the EM waves in the direction of the receiver. So receiver should be placed in the front direction of the large flat sheet reflector. So it has disadvantage that if I put a large flat sheet reflector and if large winds come, it will get hindered by this large wind. It will get disturbed, and also it can be rusted largely by the rains and winds. So now coming to the small flat sheet reflector, because it is largely hindered by the wind and corrosion and all, so now we have small flat sheet reflector. It's the same thing in a smaller dimension. So now if I have a thin linear antenna which is connected to the feed line and a small reflecting surface behind the thin linear antenna, so this is also acting like a reflector antenna and it will transmit the waves in the front direction only. Now I'll diminish the size of this reflecting surface so as to make it a thin linear segment. So now this is my thin linear segment which is acting like a reflector surface. So now this is my thin linear antenna which is connected again to a feed line. I hope you know that the radiation pattern of thin linear antenna is bidirectional in nature. So if I have thin linear antenna, its radiation pattern would look like this. So it will get reflected back by this reflecting surface. And now, depending upon the length of the distance between this reflecting surface, it would get added to this portion of the EM wave. So now it can get added constructively or destructively. It is placed such as the addition is done in constructive way, and we get an amplified version of the radiation pattern in the front side of the antenna. So now the next thing is active corner reflector. So now this surface acts like my active corner antenna when alpha is nearly equal to 180 degrees. So this angle is nearly equal to 180 degrees, and this structure is acting like an active corner antenna. This is my point source, and when the radiations from this point source reaches this active corner reflector, it gets reflected back. So now this structure represents my active corner reflector. Now I hope you can understand, in square corner reflector my alpha should be equal to 90 degree. Again, my element, that is point source, is present here, and from my point source various radiations will go and which will reflect back. Now next type of reflector is parabolic reflector. Parabolic reflector is in the shape of a parabola. In the front, point source is placed. And this is the condition I am showing when my point source is placed at the focal length. So all the radiations which go from the focal length will convert into parallel. So if I have spherical type of waves from the point source, it would convert into parallel type of radiations. So now we'll come to elliptical reflector. So I'll make an elliptical surface first. Now if I have some portion of this elliptical surface, and I'll put my antenna element here, or I can say it acting as a point source. So now my radiation would go to the reflecting surface and reflect back. Now next thing is circular reflector. Now making a circle, putting the antenna element at the center. So now this, I didn't make a perfect circle, so this should be a perfect circle, and the radiation go here and then reflect back. So this is called my circular reflector. Now how a hyperbola looks like, it looks like this. So now this is my antenna element and this is my reflecting surface. Radiations would go and reflect. So now we have an active element and a passive element in all of them. So active element is connected to the feed line and passive element is not connected to the feed line. So in this thin linear antenna is my active element. This flat sheet reflector is my passive element. In this case also, thin linear antenna active element, small flat sheet reflector passive element. Here as well, thin linear antenna active element, thin sheet reflector passive element. Here active corner reflector passive element, and the point source is acting as a active element. Active element, passive element, active element, passive element, active element, passive element, active element, passive element, active element, passive element. So I saw that in all of the cases my reflector antenna is acting like a passive element, and the antenna, which is the bidirectional antenna placed in the front of the reflector antenna, is acting like an active element. So I hope you understood the basics of reflector antenna and its types. So I'll conclude this session here. So I hope you like this video. Like this video, subscribe this channel, and stay tuned for the further videos. Thank you.